you got the juice. I've been underground making moves, but I'm in the night, let's prove. If you're down, girl, come through. You got the.
All right, Joey, how you going?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm not too bad. Show me what's on your nails today. What have you got going on?
So I took them off because they were really annoying me, but I still have, I'll give you the better look. So it's like that on this hand.
Yeah.
And then I left it here, but my friend Mannequin, my friend Victoria did them. But yeah, it was time to trim them. So like they're looking a bit janky at the moment, but they're still there.
I was going to ask if you'd ever been to her salon because I saw in your little promo video for 2 Feet, like when you were giving yourself a pedicure, I was like, is that Mannequin Hand Studios? I've never been there. But I was like, it's a bit iconic, those checkerboard floors.
It's so iconic. And it's in Newtown. So it's like this really great spot in this random like building with like some lawyers and stuff. And then this really, you open up the door, it's like this really cool studio.
Where are you right now?
I'm in Annandale. I just had friends with coffee with some friends, and then I'm gonna have a session with some friends later. So I just thought I'd sit in the sun for a little bit.
Oh, that's really nice. So you're a Brizzy kid. I'm originally a Brizzy kid. When did you move down to Sydney?
4 years ago, I think. I think it was December. I was like around this time 4 years ago, and I was like, I'm just gonna pack some bags and go down, and just drove my car down and was sort of like, I'll just go for the summer and like do a like a small rental situation, and sort of was like, I don't think I want to go back. So that was why I'm here, why you're stuck with me in the city.
Why you keep following me around? No,
I know,
definitely been here way longer than I have. Okay, so did you come up through like the Brisbane club scene then? When did it all begin? How did Young Franco happen?
So I think there was this really called Record Store and in Brisbane, and I went there a lot. And
what, like Rocking Horse Records or something?
No, it was more this one called Butterbeats. And it's like a Fortitude Valley one. It's more a bit more like hip hop soul oriented, like a bit more secondhand. And then I just like kept annoying them enough that I was like, they were telling me about like a record store like meetup that they did on Sundays and people used to go to, and I met people through there, and then like met people within like the local scene, and then met like a guy called Benji who ran a club called TV's Bowler Bar at the time, and then kept growing it from there. It's a very niche Brisbane story that I think only Brisbane people will like not relate to, but like understand the locations and stuff.
Yeah, I can see you just jumping around the streets of Fortitude Valley just like a little kid, be like, hey guys, let me in.
Totally. Music is here. And like I'm sure you did the same. Like I used to email like venues as like, oh, De La Soul's playing, like do you reckon it's all ages? It's like, of course it's not all ages, you idiot. Like yeah.
But, dude, like the days of Alumbra Lounge under 18 gigs, those are a highlight.
See, I never went to them. I think I went to one Yves Klein Blue Lost Dinosaurs show at the Brisbane Powerhouse. And then, like, that was the best. Like, so good.
Okay, so at what point did you ditch, like, studying engineering and just go full Franco?
I think I was 21 and I, like, kind of was toying with the idea of, like, just I kept going back for a semester and then coming back and sort of was like, I think it wasn't serving me in a way that I wasn't getting fulfilled, and I didn't see myself in that world. And I was like, I transitioned more so than just did the whole make it or break it thing. I think I needed to like transition and make myself move from that world and like, you know, started getting work and doing international shows and stuff. I was like, this, you know, it was either that or staying at university and sitting an exam I didn't care about. So it was sort of a no-brainer.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Just like dip your toes in and then go slide right into there. Mm. Were you always being likened to a Franco brother? Was that something that happened through high school? Where did the name Young Franco come about?
That was my middle name's Francis.
Oh, okay. I mean, but there is a resemblance, right? Like people would be like, oh, it looks like a Franco.
I think so. I think that was sort of like a silly joke. And then I started doing like local sets under that name. And then I was like, I wasn't using an O at the time. It was Y-U-N-G. And then I was like, this is stupid. I should just add an O. And then I was like, oh, this kind of, it got to the point where I don't really think about that much, but I realized that was the origins of it. So, yeah, interesting.
Yeah, pretty cute. All right, let's talk about your music then. Congrats on 2 Feet.
Thank you.
What a freaking awesome tune. I'm loving everything that you're doing with Pell. How did you guys link up?
So I hit him up personally. Oh, actually, no. There was a I hit his record. I knew one of his record label people, and he teed it up at the it's Ultra Records, and he teed it up, and we met, and it was just really nice. It was like just knowing. I thought I knew, like knowing some, like meeting someone for the first time, but sort of think you knew him forever.
Yeah.
In this weird way, and it was like, hey, what do you think of this? And he was like, sure. And he just got on it. I was like, it's pretty good. And that was that. 2 Feet was actually the first song we wrote together. And then we wrote Juice like a week after or something. So it's actually quite a special song for me, because we kind of just wrote, that was the first song we ever wrote. And I was like, yeah, really proud of it. And kind of knew something was, it was special from the moment we started on it.
Is there a third song? Is there a fourth song with him? Are you sitting on a whole
bank? Like a million songs. So it's good. And all of them, I'm like, oh, this is really good. This is really good. So I will send it to you, but I can't send the world it yet.
Yes, I would love that. And I mean, not mad if you just release all of them. Like, people won't be like, oh, this is all now.
Yeah. And yeah, exactly. And if I believe in them, I feel like that's enough, you know?
Yeah, exactly. When you collaborate with someone like that, are you like, okay, this is the name of the track I'm thinking, just go forth with your lyrics? Or is it quite more like collaborative with those top lines? How does it work?
So that one, I was in the studio with Pell, and like he was taking the lead on it. And sort of, I feel like he's just so talented. He really can just do anything. And he kind of gets, if he likes it, he kind of just goes for it. And, you know, we'll just... I think that's what's great about him, is he's got so such diversity. Like, he can be on trap stuff, and he can be on like my music, which is like kind of disco or whatever, like dance music. And then, you know, he can be on like hip hop stuff and sing. And so he kind of just comes in with his own spin on it, which is cool. Sometimes I work with people and they just send me something and it's done, which is great. But this particular one was like us both. But he and I kind of did one or two lyric ideas, and he like was like, yeah, and like my lyric ideas are crap, but like there's that little bit he can piece into like his whole story, I guess.
Yeah, it's like almost like a little homage to your input. Yeah. What are you listening to at the moment? Because your sound is definitely, I mean, it's still holistically disco, but you're now pulling in more of these like hip-hop threads. Is that all something that, like, I don't know, is there artists in your zeitgeist that you're kind of drawing that on?
I kind of have, the thing I've been listening to lately is probably, I think just standard, like, stuff, like, in that indie pop world. Like, I just love Tyler, and I love Steve Lacy, and I love, like, but I also love, like, Prince, and, like, been listening to a lot of his stuff, and even just like Muramasa's new stuff is really great, and it's like helped me dig deeper into like a bit of punk and like trying to play a bit more instruments and stuff and work with people in different worlds.
Okay, so we're going into a bit more of an experimental, you know, throwing shit at the wall, seeing what happens. What's next? What are we all working towards?
I just finished off the next one, which is exciting. I've never had a song in like sort of rotation-y, like in just come out and then have the next one ready to go. So that's really exciting. And so that next one's done, and or at least getting mixed right now. So I'm really excited to have that ready to go once 2 Feet sort of like has enough time to breathe. And then just tying up a bunch of old, like other stuff. Like I've got like a bunch of demos I wrote in the last few months that I want to just like send out to people and see what happens.
Oh, that's exciting. Okay. So All right, a lot more collabs. Hey, hit me up. No, I'm kidding. I don't know.
It's not done without the Tate rap verse.
Yo, you don't know it yet.
I don't know.
All right, final question, Joey. So I know you've been getting into a bit of the Nintendo Switch this year. What is your favorite track on Mario Kart 8?
Okay, so this might be controversial, but it's the Haunted Mansion.
One.
That's pretty good. It's
classic.
It's pretty classic. I used to always play on the Wii and like Rainbow Road would just kill you. Do they have Rainbow Road on the Switch?
Yeah,
and it's painful.
Anyone who suggests that, you're like, we just can't be friends. You're just here to
kill exactly. Me. They need like, you know how like in bowling games they have like bars for like,
so you don't like
the bumpers? You don't
like the bumpers. I think we need bumpers in Mario Kart.
That's full on cheating. Not allowing you in my game then.
I need those like safety nets so that I don't get too frustrated.
Man, okay. Joey, thank you so much for chatting with me and congrats again on 2 feet. It's wonderful.
Thanks, Tay. Thanks so much.